Hello guys, we are back with our next set of series. In this series, we are going to start the fifth unit of artificial intelligence, guys. Okay, so first let us go through the first concept, that is nothing but case grammar, guys. So basically, if you write anything, how the computer can understand, how it is done syntactically, semantically, there are many kind of words which we will be considering as case grammar, guys. Okay, so let us start the case grammar in this lecture. We'll be discussing in detail about it, guys, don't worry. Okay, case grammar is nothing but it is a theory which was proposed by an American linguist called J. Phillimore. So J. Phillimore in 1968 for representing the linguistic knowledge that removes the strong that shows the strong distinction between the syntactic and semantic knowledge of a language. So it is going to represent you the differences between the syntactic and semantic knowledges. Okay, so he initially introduced six different cases, guys. Those are nothing but agentive, that is nothing but agent, objective, object, instrumental, it is nothing but instrument, dative, indirect object, factive, result of the action, location, location of the action. Okay, so these are the six agents which he had decided. So basically these are the three main agents, guys. These three are again replaced in future by some other agents. So the goal of the case grammar is to extract deeper meaning of a particular sentence and express in the form of case mentioned above. So any kind of statement they want to mention in these six parts, guys. Okay, so similarly we know that different sentences will be having different meanings. So the semantic difference is nothing but you will be getting the same meaning from the sentence, but the way it is organized will be different. That is nothing but semantic changes. Fine. Okay, so different meanings would lead to different case structures, but different syntactic structures with the same meaning would map to the similar structure. Okay, so in a sentence, let us take an example. So the door was broken by John with a hammer. So he broke the door with a hammer. So using hammer, John broke the door. So both the sentences are giving the same meaning. So John broke the door with hammer. Here hammer is an instrument and John is the actor and the door is the object. So if you observe here, in both the statements, the things are quite common. So in this situation, we can say that these are semantically same. Okay, semantically same, whereas they are syntactically different, guys. Fine. Okay, so if you ask me that what will be the syntactically same then. So syntactically, if you observe here, the mother and the cake, here the initial parts, those are nothing but the agent or the object are changing, whereas the rest of the sentence is constant. So basically the first sentence is not possible, but it's given in the books, guys. So the best example for syntactically but semantically different is nothing but mom baked for 1 hour, cake baked for 1 hour. Here mom is an agent, whereas the object, cake, is an object, so which is baked for 1 hour. Fine. Okay, so okay, that's what I have written here. So these are the few popular cases, guys. That is nothing but action, agent. Action is nothing but what event has occurred. Agent is nothing but who did it. Objective is nothing but what it included. Benefits are nothing but who got benefited with that. Time is nothing but when it has happened. Location is nothing but where it has happened. So if you take a small example, John gave an apple to Mike in the kitchen. So we are having the location, we are having the object, we are having the agent, we are having the object. Okay, so like that we are having different things, right? So if you write it in a small table, it will be action is nothing but giving, agent is John, object is apple, benefited is Mike because he is giving to Mike, right? So Mike, time is nothing but past, he already gave it, location is nothing but kitchen. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this case study. So in this way, we'll be dividing each and every sentence into submodules, guys. So I hope everyone got a small idea. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the web, semantic web, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.